guys, welcome to my channel. So my name is Maria and today I'm here with another university advice type of video. So I just decided to combine my main tips for you to write your dissertation. So if you are in the process of writing your dissertation or if you will start to write your dissertation soon, I hope that this video can be helpful to you. So my first advice is actually for you to set a time scale early in the process. This really helped me to keep up with the work that I had to do. So basically, I divided my time scale in 6 different stages. My first stage was writing chapters and I decided to do it from March to August. Then because my dissertation is a research project, I decided to design my survey in March. Then I planned to collect my data from April to May. Then I schedule my data analysis for June and July. And then my university required me to do a dissemination report, which had to be submitted in August. And then for September, there's my final deadline. So besides setting a time scale, I would also recommend you to set daily tasks. Basically, the first thing I do every day before I start working is actually to go on my notes and I write which goals I have for that day. It can just be like reviewing a certain article, for instance. My third advice is for you to be flexible in this process. Life happens and things change, and actually I had to readjust my project because COVID-19 happened. So of course I had to do some adjustments to my project and I even had to change my time scale a little, but at least having a time scale in the beginning helped me to make all of these adjustments as well. So basically, you'll have to accept that changes are gonna happen and that just makes part of the process. My fourth advice is for you to use academic search engines and academic social networks. For example, you have ResearchGate and Academia as well, and you can use these websites to look for peer-reviewed articles, which is very important if you are writing a dissertation. My fifth advice is to start writing as soon as you can. I know that this is obviously a personal preference, but I don't really like to spend weeks just reading. Even though if you start writing in the beginning of the process, you'll have to do a lot of changes, at least it feels like you're kind of engaging with the process of writing. Writing really helps me to understand everything that I am reading and everything that I'm researching. So I would recommend you to start writing as soon as you can. And of course, you'll have to be flexible once again to make some adjustments. Also, programs like Adobe Acrobat Reader can become very helpful. I really like to use that program on my iPad, and this program will allow you to underline what you think is more relevant, to add some notes. Once you have a lot of articles to write about, it really helps you to have your keywords highlighted and notes added. Also, I would advise you to organize the articles that you need to read by different folders, for instance. So basically, if you have to read some articles on transformational leadership, you will create a folder of transformational leadership and then organizational trust. And if you are going to do a quantitative dissertation as well, you will need articles to design your surveys. So I would also recommend you to put the articles related to some specific scales on those folders, or create some folders just for the scales. So this way you'll have everything organized by folders, and that will become very helpful when you have hundreds of articles. And also, I tend to rename the articles for the author's name. So basically, each folder will represent a certain subject, and then you'll have the different authors. And I think that this will really help you to find what you're looking for. Last but not least, I would recommend you to get feedback early and get it often. Pay a lot of attention to the feedback that your supervisor will give you. Allow yourself enough time to make changes. You will need a supervisor to help you, so it's very important to have time to do all of the necessary changes so your supervisor will be able to check everything again and get back to you with his comments and recommendations. So basically, these are my main tips on how to write a dissertation, and I feel like they have been helping me quite a lot. So I really hope I can help you guys with my advice as well. And that's pretty much it. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video, and I will see you in my next one.